Hello and welcome to Pro Trader Strategies Market Commentary for Friday, May the 24th. My name is Eric Wilkinson. Some of you may recognize me as the Wolfman from CNBC, Fox Business, or even the Wall Street Journal. But I'm here to teach you some different strategies you can implement into your portfolios, but please do that in your own way. Also, remember, past performance of any trading system or methodology is not necessarily indicative of future results. All right, having that out of the way, let's move it on over to the economic data. We got retail sales across the pond out of Great Britain, and they came in slightly better than expected, coming in at unchanged. Expected to be a negative 0.3 in there. They did revise last month's number up slightly from 1.1 to 1.2, and nice revision there. So better than expected. Was not expecting to see some good retail sales coming out of Great Britain. And then back here in the United States, we got core durable goods orders. Remember, durable goods orders are anything you purchase that is going to last longer than 3 years. So for instance, washers, dryers, cars, airplanes, if you're in the market for buying an airplane. Anyway, core durable goods strips out those more volatile seasonal aspects of the number, and it came in at unchanged, which was slightly lower than the expected 0.1% positive. So then we got durable goods orders where we add in those ancillary items, and it came in at negative 2.1, expected to be a negative 2. So worse than expected there. We are seeing automobiles really start to slough off with the purchasing, and that is one of the first things that we see as consumers pulling back on buying is those cars. So when cars start buying, that's the car sales start going down. That's one of the first signs that there is trouble ahead. All right, and that was about it. So core durable goods came in slightly lower than expected there. So let's move on to the overall markets. We've got crude oil right now unchanged. I talked about this yesterday. We've got this Fibonacci area that we've been looking at. Yesterday we came down, blew through the 200-day moving average, and then right through the $59 a barrel area, which I thought was going to act as more of a resist or support area. This little line right there, I thought was going to act as the support, but we have found that this $58 a barrel is our support. So we're going to be looking for that as being the major support and or resistance. Right now it's acting as support. Once we get below it, that acts as resistance on the way back up. So that is going to be our little star that we're going to be looking for. If we start breaking down below this $58 a barrel, so settling down below that, like we are right now, much further than that even, we are going to be looking for this market to want to come down to the time POC. So this is for the time. This is where the most time's been spent. The most volume has been spent up here at around 68. So we could see the market roll back over down to those areas as well. And as it bounces back in between here, we should see it start to want to fill in some of this volume node and create a big bell curve there, which is usually what the market profile has a tendency to kind of build out and create a nice large bell curve over time. And I think we're going to be seeing that happening for the next month or so anyway, unless some major economic data changes that. We've got gold moving to the upside. Yeah, it is in negative territory right now. That's, you know, it feels very bullish right now because we're seeing the equities start to slide. Overnight was starting to drive higher, but we're starting to see some of those cover. The economic data not so great. A lot of this tariff in the news is really weighing on the market. Now, I'm not a fan of tariffs, don't get me wrong, but the fact of the matter is this tax on China is just that. It's a tax. It's a federal tax that we feel in other ways. Now, yes, China came back and tried to tax us back by throwing tariffs on our stuff, but they don't import our goods. So that doesn't really concern us. When we are the net importer, then it hurts them more than us. So that's what they're trying to do, is to get China to a point where they start importing some of our goods as well. Then we move over to the bonds. Yesterday, bonds trading up that 151.15 area. Yesterday, after this daily market commentary, I threw in some Fibonacci's extension using these points here for the Fibonacci to get the extension. Threw it up right there, and you can see came up and tested my resistance area on those extension. We failed on that. Looked like we tried, we're going to go up there and test that again today, but came up just short of that. I think that the bonds are just overdone. The Fed is signaling they are not going to do anything. They're going to let these interest rate hikes meld a little bit. I've been talking about this as well. They aren't going to do anything for the rest of 2019. They aren't going to swallow their pride and lower interest rates right away and say that they were wrong and that they should have been listening to me, because I've been telling them they were wrong by raising probably the last 75 basis points, going a little bit over what they needed to do. They should have let those meld a long time before heading into even the Christmas holiday. All right, VIX is in negative territory. We're still in the teens, which is what we'd like to see as options traders. We want to see some volatility in these markets that creates opportunity. VIX is coming off just a little bit today, but the fact of the matter is the markets really haven't at this point decided what direction they want to go. We've got the Dow Jones Industrial Average in positive territory by about 60 points. Yesterday blew through that 200-day moving average. It's not probably going to act as a support and resistance as much as we would normally expect, because it lines up very nicely with, as you can see, the point of control. It came down, rested on that area, and then today we're kind of pulling up and away, but I don't expect us to really want to break out of this area anytime in the near future, at least not aggressively, let's say. And then we move over to the NASDAQ. NASDAQ is in positive territory by about 20 as well. You know, it's as it close in on this 72.30 area, that's where we started seeing a lot of buying coming in. Market wanted to resist this area well before that. And we also have this magnet right above us. So we've seen the Dow and the NASDAQ test these points of control in previous areas. We haven't seen that really show up on the E-mini S&Ps. They're in positive territory as well by about 8 points. But the thing I want to talk about here is we have this point of control right here that has been untested recently. We've seen all the other ones tested, but we know that this is going to act as a magnet. The market is going to want to go down to that 2800. I think that the market needs to test that. It's only 20 some odd points away, but I think 28 even is going to be want to be tested. And we also have this little magnet right here that is kind of drawing the market down. So anytime you have a point of control that close, it just is almost inevitable that the market needs to go down there and visit that area. All right, take a look at the E-mini S&Ps. Overnight inventory got very long, probably some short covering going on from some of those weaker hands, as you can see here. But as soon as the day session opened, I thought that they were going to kind of continue on with that and forget about flushing out that overnight inventory. But sure enough, we slammed them down and even tested yesterday's point of control, which is a big intraday trade idea where people look for the market to test previous points of control. This being a point of control right here that the market will eventually want to revisit. I believe I'm in the camp anyway that I think the market is going to go roll over and test 2800 even before we get there. Yes, it came up slightly shy of that. Some might say that that was a test. I really believe it needs to go down there and kiss it because of that point of control there. All right, and then we move over to the last thing I'm looking at, Tesla. I thought Tesla was on the open, going to make today a confirmation of a bottom. But the way the market's reacting and starting to slide off, it's really not doing that. So as much as I want to play some upside in Tesla and do some premium selling strategies, like sell some puts like I just did on the webinar yesterday, we talked about even putting the short puts on around Tesla. But I'm waiting for the market to confirm my assumption. And none of the markets have confirmed my assumption. So what's the thing to do is you sit on your hands. And that's on the floor, we used to say, sit on your hands, because as soon as you put your hands up, you started trading. So you sit on your hands, make sure you don't get those hands up in the air and start the auction. So I'm gonna sit on my hands here in my office to make sure that I don't do anything ahead of my confirmation of my assumption, because I've gotten cut a couple of times trying to catch those knives. I'm going to hold off for right now until the market starts shaking things out a little bit better than that. All right, that's all I got for you guys. I hope everybody has a great extended weekend. Stay safe and be happy, I guess, for lack of anything else to say. If you can't take that, take it easy.